light is refracted when it encounters a boundary between two different materials. However, refraction can also occur when light encounters a change in temperature and density within the same material. By using a candle flame to heat the surrounding air, the effect of temperature on the index of refraction of air will be examined. Variations in the index of refraction of air are difficult to observe directly. In order to clearly see these variations, an image called a Schlieren image will be produced by using a special arrangement of lenses. The production of a Schlieren image requires the use of a perfectly parallel beam of light. This is accomplished by using a laser as a point source of light. By positioning the laser and its attached beam spreader at the focal point of a large converging lens, the diverging light striking the lens is refracted to form a wide parallel beam. This parallel beam then passes through the air above the candle flame and is incident on a second converging lens. Some of the light rays remain parallel as they pass through the air above the candle and are thus brought to a focus at the focal point of the second converging lens. These rays then continue on and form an image on the screen. Viewing the inverted image of the candle flame and laser beam shows that uniform illumination takes place with the laser beam, with no resulting picture of the flame's effect on the surrounding air. In order to observe what is happening to this heated air, one additional step must be taken to create the Schlieren image. An obstacle or shield in the form of a small pin is placed into the beam at the focal point of the second lens. Only the very tip of the pin's pointed end is used. Great care is taken in positioning the pin to assure that only those rays converging to a very narrowly defined focal point are blocked. With the laser beam being shielded by the pin, the screen is observed to be dark. However, if the candle is now lit, an interesting result is observed. The inverted image of the flame appears. But this time, the laser light takes on an unusual pattern. What is being observed is the refraction or bending of laser light. Keeping in mind that the entire image is upside down, the refraction occurs as the laser light travels from relatively cool air to the hot air above the candle flame. The Schlieren image makes visible the light which has been refracted due to a change in air temperature and air density. The pin only blocks the rays which have converged at the focal point, which means that only those rays which entered the lens parallel to its axis have been blocked. Rays of light which have been refracted by the change in air temperature enter the lens on a path which is not parallel to the lens axis, and thereby do not converge at the focal point. These rays are not blocked by the pin and are able to continue on and form an image on the screen. The only laser light which is therefore capable of getting through to the screen is light which is refracted by the change in air temperature and air density. The pattern of laser light shows the regions where the rising heat from the flame has slightly changed the index of refraction of air. It is in these regions where the heated air has become less dense, causing the index of refraction to be decreased. Using a soldering iron as a heat source instead of a flame, the Schlieren image dramatically reveals the refraction which takes place when light encounters air of a non-uniform temperature.